This conference will now be recorded.
Next, we'll discuss availability check and transfer of requirements. The main function of availability check is to check whether and how the system will check the availability of the materials, stock of the materials, and generate the requirements for material planning. In SAP, availability check is carried out in the sales order and delivery for an order item. And also it creates MRP records and passes them into MRP. And this availability check is carried out at plant level. Suppose when an end user specifies the customer material number in the sales order system, has to confirm the quantity on a particular day. So as to confirm the quantity on a particular day, system should know the requirements of the particular material for sales order or delivery. As a result, the system can generate the requirements of the order or delivery for a material by a function called transfer of requirements. Actually, this availability check topic is more and more widely comes in sales and distribution module. Okay, this transfer of requirements, ATP means availability to promise. Okay. And how this availability to promise is calculated: warehouse stock plus planned receipts minus planned issues. So planned receipts like planned orders, production orders, purchase requisitions, purchase orders, stock transfers, stock in transit, stock at inspection, etc. And planned issues like sales orders and deliveries, etc. Okay. Now, even you see all these configuration settings also, these are not totally done by the sales and distribution consultant. Okay. So basically, the availability, the functionality of availability check is the system will check availability of the stock of the material and generate the requirements for material planning. Okay. Now, whenever we are delivering the finished material to the customer, the system will check how much stock is available, and for that much of stock only, the system will confirm the quantity and the date. That is the functionality of basic functionality of availability check. And here, as per the business requirement, you want to maintain the availability check at customer sales order or at delivery. Let us say, for example, you have the stock of the material and you have created a purchase order. Sorry, you have created a sales order more than the available stock. Okay. But at the time of delivery, the system will not confirm as per the sales order quantity. It will throw the error saying that deficit of stock. Okay, based upon this availability check. Okay, so these are the configurations what you are able to see, all these steps coming from sales and distribution. And even in our PP, we have the availability check settings. Now I will show it where exactly we'll maintain it. That is from our PP side, SPRO. This is reference IMG production. Material requirement planning. Material requirement planning, procurement proposals, planned orders, define availability check for components. Now first, availability check in material requirement planning. So this settings comes under production planning module, and whatever the configuration settings we have seen, these are all done by the sales and distribution consultant. This comes under sales and distribution. Now coming to the PP side, we have to know this. So checking rule, where you want to check, and these settings are standard even in the real time, guys. Checking rule A, at the time of order create, SD order. Checking rule B, at the time of delivery. Okay, at the time of order create and at the time of order delivery. So make sure that these availability check rules are maintained. If not, click on new entries and we can create this. Next, determine check. So here also, availability check 01 daily requirements and checking rule SG order, and make sure that availability check 01 checking rule BSG delivery is maintained. If it is maintained, well and good. If not, click on new entries and maintain this availability check. And here you can see, suppose if you say availability check 01 checking rule BSG delivery, click on details, so you can see including purchase orders, including reservations, sales requirements, including deliveries, everything. Come back. Next, click on plant. Click on plant. Now here, to your plant, maintain the availability check rule. PP. See. Go back. Next, MRP group. MRP group. Select the plant 1000 and MRP group. Click on details and maintain the check group. PP. Press enter. Okay. So these are the settings related to availability check in production planning. Okay. And whatever the configuration settings you are going to see, so these are done by the sales and distribution consultant. So we nowhere involved in the configuration settings related to sales and distribution module. Okay. Now we'll go for execution part. Coming to the execution part, steps to perform for availability check. As usual, create a material master
MMOR
with FERT finish. Then create bomb.
Yeah.
Just I'm giving the steps. Then create work center. Then create routing. Okay. Then you can do the production order and all, or else I'll create GR without production order. Normally, we need to follow the regular process, but I'll do using the transaction code MB1C moment I 521. Okay. So let's restart the process. I'll create one material master. I'll copy from so like this. You can copy from the existing material and then you can create a material also. So material 2115 is created. Then as usual, I'll maintain the remaining master datas. So in PP, these are all common. If you want to create a material master and if you want to process it, compulsory, you need to maintain all the master datas. Enter work center, you can use existing work center, and then you can go to create a routing. Enter usage 1, status 4 list from node size, then click on operations. Enter the work center, press enter. So double click on the control key. Enter, save. Okay. Now you can create a production order, you can release a production order, goods issue, confirm. This is your regular process, you can do it. Now directly I'll maintain the stock by using this functionality, GR without production order. Either you can follow your regular cycle process or else you can use this. So go to the transaction code MB1C. Movement type 521, plant and store location. Material and quantity. Let's say I'm showing 100. So now go to stock overview, MMBE. Material, plant and store location. Exit. Now available stock is 100. Okay, fine.
Okay.
So after doing this,
you check.
Monitor stock overview. MMBE. I found that the stock is, for example, 100 tons. Now I will create a sales order.
Okay.
A01. Now observe, guys, all of you. Order type OR, sales organization, distribute channel, division, sales office, sales group. Present. Sold to party, enter customer number, PO number and PO date, material and now let's say I'll enter 150. Press enter. Oh, we did not maintain the language. Not a problem. Now observe what happens. We are delivering the finished metal to the customer. How much quantity? 150 tons. Now observe, guys, the system has displayed a screen, availability control. Yeah. Confirm quantity, how much it is? 100. And the remaining 50 is for, it will give for next date. Because in the system, the stock available is 100. Now let's say for example I will create a sales order for 150, for example. Okay, we'll see what happens.
Right,
double click on the material, click on shipping tab, maintain, plan, store location and shipping point. Click on shipping tab, maintain, plan, store location, shipping point, then click on conditions, enter. And enter the condition type PR0. It is a standard condition type in sales and distribution module. And enter the amount. Press enter. go back. Now I am going to create a sales order for 150 tons. Okay, fine. Let's create and note down the required delivery date. Save the document. So at the time of order create also, the system has checked the availability of the stock of the material and it has confirmed only 100. But what I did, I am creating the sales order for 150 tons of the material. Will the system allow to create a delivery for 150 tons or 100? We will see now. Now go to the transaction code VL01N. Create delivery. So after this, next step, create delivery with reference to sales order VL01. Shipping point, delivery date and sales order number. Enter shipping point, delivery date and sales order number. Press enter. If you click on picking tab, all of you see guys, for how much quantity is delivering? 100 only. Okay. So the system has checked the availability of the stock of the material. Even though I create a sales order for 150 tons, but the system is confirming only 100. Okay. Let's say I will remove this 100. I will enter 150. We'll see. And pick quantity 150. Press enter. The system will throw the message. What is the message?
We have only 100.
Only 100 tons of the material 2115 is available. Okay, so it means even though if you create a sales order for more than the stock available, but yeah, the system will confirm only 100 at the time of order create, order delivery.
Yeah, so that's now my here,
100 only you can do it.
Yeah, got the point?
Click on post. So this is a functionality of availability check in MRP in production planning. Delivery has been saved. Now even if you go to the stock over here, the stock will become zero.
No way.
Got it?
You know.
Create PGI, we call it a PGI, post goods issue. VL02N. Then after that, sales people will create sales billing, whatever it is, sales invoice, followed by the SD people. Sales invoice VF01. Done. And finally, you can go and check that's it. Any doubts guys on this topic?
Yes, it's clear, easy.
So this is how the availability check,
yeah,
in MRP in PP takes place. Okay guys, fine. Now we have done the confirmation, production or confirmation. Okay. Right. No, see here. There are two types of confirmation of the production order, guys. CO15 and CO11. This is also very important. In CO15 is a transaction code for production order confirmation, where you confirm the total order in one step. It means there we will not enter any operation details such as yield, scrap, etc. Suppose if you have 10 to 15 operations in that order, we can confirm via CO15, then all the operations will be automatically confirmed with the planned data maintained in the routing. This is what we are seeing. There is another transaction code for production order confirmation, CO11N. In this transaction code, you can confirm operation by operation, where it will display setup time, machine time, labor time, yield, scrap for each and every operation. So one by one operation is confirmed so that we can record the yield, scrap, activity, or whatever the operations you have done it, so that the actual cost can be known. These two are important, guys. Okay?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Then after that, I will tell you what is this milestone confirmation. So first, I will resolve this scenarios. Confirmation and CO15 and CO11. Let's say I will create a production order. So I'm creating for 100. Okay. So I'm creating a production order. Check the availability of the material. Yes, availability of the material is there. So, release production order CO02. Click on release order. Save. Next, goods issue. To reservation and reservation number. What is the production order? Just 3697.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we have maintained the back machine. Okay. Because of that, you cannot create a. Now, I will create a confirmation. Now, all of you see, guys. Now, I mean, yeah. Production order confirmation CO15. I just enter the production order.
Right.
Setup. Final confirmation. Clear reservation. Save. Okay. Confirmation has been saved. Got it?
Yeah.
So at a time, whatever the operations are there, it is confirmed. Now, we'll use CO11N now. Okay. Again, I'll create a production order. Again, I'll create a production order. Hundred. Then release production order. So we cannot create goods issue because we have maintained back flushing. So automatically goods issues have been taken place. Now go to the transaction code CO11N. Now see here, enter the production order. Now in the operation drop down, it will display all your operations: lathe machine, drilling machine, punching machine, boring machine, painting, finishing, etc. So one by one, enter, press enter. See here, the system displays yield. If there is any scrap, then setup time, machine time, labor time, everything. Are you able to see, guys?
Yes, sir.
Press enter, then save. Once you save, this operation will go on, and it will display a confirmation number also. Save. So first operation is confirmed. So system says goods mount one. Save. I can enter the production order number, operation two. So once you confirm operation one, it will go. Now next is operation two.
Right.
So it will confirm all these things. It's very important, guys. What is the reason behind using production order confirmation CO15 and CO11? Then again, operation three. Set. Next, operation four. Next, operation five. And finally, operation six. That's it. Six. Okay.
Yeah.
Now I have seen the difference. What is the difference between a first normal CO15, CO11? In the CO15, at a time, the system will confirm all the operations.
Yes.
Where in the case of CO11, operation by operation, we are supposed to use it.
I don't like that.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Now my question is, my requirement is, I don't want to confirm all these operations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Suppose if I have 100 operations, I don't want to execute 100 times CO11. My requirement is, if I confirm one operation, the 100th one, the remaining operation should confirm. Is it? Yeah, guys. Then the next concept called milestone confirmation. Okay.
Yes.
We'll use milestone confirmation. And before this, if you go to CO03, now you just observe. You enter production number, press enter. If you click on this operation overview, see what type of confirmation you'll get here. CNF release, normal confirmation. Suppose if it is milestone confirmation, you'll get there it has a mile, and the status it displays as MCNF, milestone confirmation.
Okay.
So milestone confirmation means, suppose now let us say we have operations like operation one, turning, drilling, punching, assembling, painting, finishing, packaging, etc. Out of all these operations, my requirement is I will confirm only the packing, so that the system should confirm the remaining operations also. This is called milestone confirmation. It's a very, very important.
Okay.
Now you got the clear, guys. What is the confirmation of CO15? What is the functional of the confirmation of CO15, CO11N, and milestone confirmation? Okay. Now what are the settings to be done? I'll show it. So go to the transaction code OP67 or OP00. Now select the control key PP04. click on details. Now here you have confirmation. All of us here. It should be milestone confirmation 1. Press enter, save. Done. Next.
Check your PC. It's not fresh.
No.
No. Hello?
This is frozen. It's not as it
sounds. Oh.
Bear with us, guys.
Hi.
What has happened?
Just closed the.
It's not my screen, is it?
No, it's theirs.
No. I'm going to close it all down. Oh, hello.
I will be trying to reconnect to him.
Is everything okay? Hello, guys.
Hello.
Okay, let me check. Let me check. Just give me 1 second. Okay. Yeah, thank you.
This conference will now be recorded.
So we are discussing the
milestone
confirmation. Now we are doing the settings. So go to the transaction code OPK4. Select the plan and auto type PP04. Click on details. And here the option, observe carefully. In OP transaction code, select the option under the operation sequence when operation sequence to adherence.
Okay.
So these are the settings you need to do. After that, I will go to change routing CA02. Enter the finished material and plan. Press enter. Now, for the finishing operation, I will enter PP04. Save. Now, go to create a production order. Then release production order. So I'm entering backflush. Now we'll go for confirm production order CO11M. Enter the order number. Now see guys, in the operation tab, I am going to select the operation finishing operation. Observe carefully.
Okay.
Previously, one by one operations have been confirmed. Now in this case, only the finishing operation. That's it. Save. Again, you enter the production order number. If you click on the operation drop down button, you cannot see the operations. Are you able to see, guys? No values found.
I like that way.
Yes, all the operations have been confirmed. Now go to display production order CO03, enter the order number, press enter. If you click on the operation overview, now here you can see confirmation milestone.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
So this is about the different types of confirmation of the production orders. Very, very important, guys. Okay. Here we have 6 operations. Let us say, suppose if you have 20 to 35 operations. Okay.
Yeah.
So if that is the case, I want to confirm only the finishing in such a way that the remaining operations will be confirmed automatically.
Very good.
Okay. So this is about the production order confirmation. Next, we are done with the sales and operation planning, right? Yeah. Now see, what happens when you are creating a production order? Okay.
Okay.
When you create a production order, the different functions involved, that is order creation, order release, inspection lot processing, goods issues, order confirmation, goods received, order settlement. When a production order is created, the following actions are carried out. So the moment you create a production order, what happens in the system? A routing is selected, its operations and sequence are transferred to the order. The bill of material is exploded, and the items in the bill of material are transferred to the order. Reservations are generated for bill of material items held in the stock. Next, the planned costs for the production order generated. The capacity requirements are generated for the work centers. Purchase requisitions are generated for non-stock items and externally process operations. So these are the activities that takes place the moment you crash production order. What happens when you release a production order? Release of the production order is an important business function which controls the things like goods issued for order, confirmation of the order progress, etc. So the production order release function is to exercise in each production order in the transaction menu of the order header. Then after the creation of production order, this function sets the release button. So once you receive the release of production order, date specified in the metal master, schedule margin key. What happens when you confirm the production order? With the confirmation of the production order, the quantity in the operation that was produced as yield, scrap, how much quantity has been reworked, what was the work actually done, which work center was used for the operation, who carried out the operation, and you can enter confirmation shortly after completion of operation, etc. will be done during confirmation of production order. And the following business transactions can be executed via confirmation. Okay, like back flushing, automatic goods received, capacities, updating of the cost, work in process, then scrap, yield, setup time, machine time will be calculated during confirmation. And costing takes place for the production orders. So this is also very, very important. Okay. When we do goods issued to production order, it will update actual material cost. This is actually very, very important, guys. When you do goods issue of the raw material to production order, what happens? Actual material cost will take place. Confirmation of production order will update actual activity cost. The quantities and costs are updated that were occurred during the production. Technically, completion of the production order takes place when there will be no changes for the order, but stock postings can be performed. And production order settlements means you will post all the incurred costs, respective costs with planned data, actual data. And based upon the planned and actual data, the variance is also calculated accordingly. So once the order is settled, then we'll have the balance zero. Hence the process completed. Yesterday we are seeing this total time, how to close the production order. Now what is TECO? Technically complete the production order. So production order close means after the completion of confirmation settlement of the order is fully closed for the further processing. We can close the production order only when you have full settlement done and no more costs can be ordered. Then a confirmation and goods movement are no longer permitted for the order. What is meaning of closed? Closed status signifies that your order and cost object has been completed. So it means all the settlement is done, then you can close the production order. Okay. Mm-hmm. So these are the things takes place right from creation of the order up to the closing the production order. Okay, guys?
Yes.
Any doubts in this? Yesterday we have seen all these things. Now in we have seen in details now, theoretically. This costing takes place is very, very important, guys. Okay. So what happens when you do goods issue? What happens when confirmation is done? What happens when technically completed? What happens when production order settlement is done? Though we don't involve in the costing in the financial side, but for knowledge point of view, as a production PP consult point of view, as a production in charge point of view, it's better we have to know this process and all. It makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, guys. So we have seen availability check and transfer of requirements. Now, what are the prerequisites for running MRP? So this is also very, very important. The prerequisites for running MRP is, that is MRP setting, is activate MRP at plant level. Okay. So here we need to activate the indicator to plan to set up the planning file entrance. When we activate it, then the MRP takes place on that particular plant level. The transaction code is OMDU. I'll go to the transaction code, I'll show you. Okay, metal requirement planning. Click on it. So this is your plant. It is already inactivated now. If it is not activated, activate it for the plant. Set up planning file. So it was already set up the variant. So this is very important. Next, maintain MRP views for the material. So that we have seen what are the MRP 1, MRP 2, MRP 3, MRP 4, maintaining it. Next, third one, MRP plant parameters for the plant. Okay. So the MRP plant parameters are maintained in the background settings, SPRO, IMG, production, material requirement planning, plant parameters, carry out overall maintenance of plant parameters. Okay, so click on maintain, enter the plant, again click on maintain. So these are all the plant parameters which are maintained to the plant. Yeah, Nicola, come on. Okay. Hello.
Yes,
we're
watching.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So third step is maintaining MRP plant parameters for the plant. Next, what are the MRP control parameters in MRP area? Okay. Processing key, create purchase requisition, schedule agreement delivery schedule lines, create MRP list, planning mode, and scheduling are the control parameters for MRP in MRP area. Now we are using processing keys. Suppose when you are going to MD02, you have processing keys. See here, NETCH, NETPL, NUUPL. These are very important, guys. Now I'll explain this MD02 now. What is this NUUPL? Regenerative planning. When we'll use this? In this case, the system will plan the material planning for the materials within the plant, irrespective of the planning file entries. For example, out of 30,000 materials in the plant, if 20,000 materials are already done the planning, and for the remaining 10,000 materials planning is not done, then by using this key, the system will plan the material planning for all 30,000 materials.
Okay.
This key is called, this processing key is called regenerative planning. Is it clear, guys?
Yes, yes. Yes,
if you have any doubt, please ask me. When you use this NUUPL, the functionality of NUUPL is regenerative planning processing key. Example, let us say in your organization you have 30,000 materials, in which 20,000 materials have gone for planning. Still, 10,000 materials are to be gone for planning has not done. Then by using this processing key, the system will plan the for all the 30,000 materials.
Okay.
Next, NETPL, net change planning with planning horizon. What is this? Is any material that has undergone some changes since last MRP run, and those changes are in the MRP plan planning horizon. Example, let us say we have created a planned order inside the planning horizon, that is 3 months, and you created planned order for a date 5 months from now. The material is not included in the planning with NETPL. So it means all the materials will be planned within this planning horizon. The system will generate the requirements within the planning horizon. That is called net change planning with planning horizon. Very rarely we'll use it. And regularly we'll use is NETCH, net change planning. All the materials will be planned within the plan which are relevant for MRP. And those have undergone for a change since the last MRP run. For example, today MRP has planned for 100 parts, out of which 10 has gone for change. The next run, only these 10 will be planned. Got the point? Out of 100 materials, 10 materials has gone for some changes, some planning changes have been done. When you run MRP, only the planning will be run for this 10 materials. And it is mostly widely used processing key. Okay, guys.
Okay.
Is it clear? What is NETPL, NETCH, NAUPL? Next, create purchase equation. So here, depending upon the selection of the indicators, the system creates planned orders or purchase equations in the open period or in the planned orders. Next, create MRP list. So planning mode. So one, adapt planning data, re-explode BOM and routing. 3, delete and recreate planning data. Adapt to planning data means, for example, planned orders are created for the material with requirement quantity 100. And again, the quantity has been increased from 100 to 200. Then again, when you run MRP, the planner remains the same, but the quantity will be increased from 100 to 200. That is, planners are adjusted with increasing quantity. You plan for 100, but we are increasing the quantity. Then what happens when you select the adapt to planning data? It will plan for 200. Next, re-explode BOM and routing means all the existing planned orders will be there and remain the same. And once when we run MRP, the system explores the BOM and routing and generates a requirements quantities. And the third option is delete and recreate planning. So it's, for example, we create plan independent requirements for 300. Then when you run MRP, then the planners are created for 300 quantity. Scheduling means basic dates will be determined for planned outdoors. And display results before they are saved means when we create plan independent requirements for finished material, and when you try to save, the system displays the subcomponents and click on continue and save. It means we can select the option either display for requirement or you can go for the display material list. Display material list means when you run MRP MD02, the system displays all the subcomponents and the finished material. And final one is simulation mode means testing the MRP run under simulation mode. And this mode is the system will not save the results into the system. Where you have seen all these fields, guys? Observe in the transaction code MD02. Are you able to see, guys? See?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Processing key, create purchase requisition, schedule lines, create MRP list, planning mode, scheduling, and these are the indicators. So this is a functional of the transaction code MD02. Now coming to MD04 and MD05. MD04 stocks are requirement list. It is a dynamic where it gives the exact planning situation of the material. What is MD05? It is a static where it gives the situation of the last planning run for the material. For example, if you take MD04, when we convert planned order to production order and when we refresh MD04, the planned order is replaced with production order. That we have seen. But not in MD05. In MD05, it will not replace the production order. Again, when we run MRP MD02, then again planned order is replaced with production order in MD05. That is, in MD05, changes takes place for next MRP run. Is it clear? Please ask me if you have any doubts in this case.
It's all right. It's a bit complicated, but it's okay.
Okay, guys?
Yeah.
If you use the transaction code MD04, planned order is converted to production order.
Yeah.
And it is replaced with planned order with production order. But not in MD05.
Yeah, that's clear, yes.
Okay. Suppose, again, if you run the MRP for that material, then at that time, when the changes takes place, in the MD05, changes will be taken in the next MRP run, in MD05. For example, suppose if the user deletes the planned orders in MD05, then planned orders will not be deleted in MD05. Got the point? This is one of the major difference between the transactions between planned orders generally displayed in MD05 and can be seen in MD05. You can delete the planned orders in MD04, but it cannot be deleted in MD05. It can be seen in MD05.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, guys, because it is a static, whereas MD04, it is a dynamic. Now, analyzing the MRP results. So analyzing MRP results means when we done the MRP MD04 execution, independent requirements, sales orders, reservations are displayed, okay, with minus sign, and all receipts, planned orders or production orders are displayed plus sign, but indicator will not be displayed. Now let us say if you create a planned order requirements weekly format, okay, when you run MD02, if you monitor MD04, then the option it displays period totals, then here we can see requirement dates, weeks and months. And we have filter on and off that I will show it in the transaction. And show overview tree also, pegged requirements. Okay, so these are all comes under. Now, methods of executing planning run. So there are three ways of executing a planning run: plant level, online, background job, material level. So plant level means using the transaction code MD01. To run MRP for all the materials, we'll use the transaction code MD01. Okay, you just enter the plan, then system will run the planning for all the materials under the plan 1000.
Correct.
Okay, then, and there is a transaction code background job MDBT. Okay, planning run plan level will be background job is performed by using the transaction code MDBT, which is can be performed daily, weekly, monthly, fortnight, etc. And MD02 transaction functionality is planning will take place for a single material by using the transaction code MD02. Now next we have to know what is this planning scope. Suppose whenever the business or the company is having multiple plans, for example, you have 1500 plans. So it is not possible to plan the requirements for all the materials in 1500 plans, isn't it? Will it possible? No. Then we create a planning scope. So as per this navigation, we'll go and we'll create a planning scope. After doing the planning scope, select the planning scope, let us say BMW. Okay, under this company they have the enter all the plans. Now assign the planning scope in MD01, then the system will widely use the planning. Now I'll show here. Observe in MD01. Scope of planning. Are you able to see here? Suppose I will enter here BMW. I will not enter the plant. Under the BMW scope, I have the plants, 1500 plants. Is it clear, guys? What is meaning of scope of planning?
Yeah.
So these are about things. Now what is this MD02, 03 and all, we'll see now. Now see, MD01, 02, 03, 04. MD01 is used for all the material planning at particular plant level. Scope of planning. MD02 means single item multi level. It means, see the example. For example, if you have a finished material A is a finished material and it has components B and C, raw materials. And further, if B has a components D and E, let us say, listen carefully, guys, what is the difference between MD01, what is the meaning of MD01 functionality, guys? If you want to run MRP for all the materials, it may be raw material, finish, semi-finish, it will be using the transaction code MD01. Okay? Yeah. And you have scope of planning. When you use scope of planning, suppose in your company, you have 1,500 plants or 2,000 plants. So it is not so easy at a time if you want to plan the materials planning for all the materials available in 2,000 plants. Then yeah. What we'll do is we'll create a scope of planning, let us say BMW. For this BMW Motors company, they have so many plants worldwide. Then these plants are assigned to the scope of planning called BMW. Then in MD01 transaction code, we'll just enter BMW scope of planning. Then the system will generate the material planning for all the materials that belongs to multiple plants.
Okay.
In MD01. Now, what is this MD02 means? Single item multi-level. See, and in a simple way, I will explain it. Suppose you have a finished material A having the subcomponents B and C. Okay. Further, this subcomponent B has a components D and E. Okay, guys. Therefore, when we run MRP using the transaction code MD02, the system will plan for all the components B, C, D, and E. Guys, are you able to understand or not? If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask.
Yeah. Okay. It is the same. Yeah. It works like this in our company.
Yeah. This transition.
We have our finished good has components which are semi.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
So it drives the MRP for everything. So yeah, we have the same here.
Yeah. So okay. So if you use the transaction code MD02, it means whatever the subcomponents all involved for the whole finished material, the planning will take place for all the components B, C, D, and E. Okay. Mm-hmm. Suppose if you use MD03, single item, single level. Example C. Let us say if you have the finished material A that has the components B and C. And further, if the component B has D and E, if you run MRP, the system will plan only the requirements for A.
Yeah.
And B and C, but not D and E.
Okay. Okay.
What's the point?
Yeah.
That is the difference. If you have any doubt, please, all of you, feel free. Don't hesitate to ask me, because MD01, MD02, MD03, 04, 05 are widely used and very, very important.
Now we're okay. I see the difference between MD01 and MD03.
Yeah.
Then it's very clear for me.
Yeah. In the case of MD02, what happens? It will plan for all the materials. Whereas in the case of MD03, if you plan for material A, the components B and C, and if components B has D and E, it will not generate the requirement for D and E. It will generate the requirement only for A, B and C. That's it.
Yeah, that's clear. Yeah. Okay.
Simple words. It's easy to understand. Okay, guys. So these are the total MRP settings, parameters, and the transaction codes we are supposed to use in the real time. Most widely used is MD02 and MD04. And one more thing, I'll show it. If you go to MD04, enter the finished material, MRP area and plan. Now you press enter, guys. Now you are able to see here the requirements of the finished material. Okay. Now if you click on this show overview tree.
Okay.
Then. And here you can see the.
Yes.
Order report, then you'll have an option. One second. Bigger requirements. And this is used for switch to period totals. What are the totals if you want to see? Now here you can see day wise, weekly wise, monthly, planning calendar wise, etc. Then close it off and you can use this option. Order report. What are the order report you have? Now here you can discuss what is an order report now. Back. And this is go to material list. You can see the material list. I think these options you are keep on using in the. You are using this transaction codes and all in your job wise.
Yes, every day.
Yeah, MD04 and all.
Yes, all the time.
Yeah, if you click on this material tab, it will display your material master.
Okay. Yeah.
This is show overview tree of your components and all. So here, give you an option. One second. employees. Filter on. Now here it will display the display filters, the display horizon, next planning, 10 days, what are receipts and all. Suppose if you want to see receipts.
All right, okay.
You can see this. Now selection rules here. Receipts, planned independent requirements, whatever the thing. Suppose if his requirements are there.
I didn't know that. I never used that way. And that's very nice.
Yeah. So these are all save settings, send mail. This is refresh button. Totals. So this is normal, regularly we'll use it. These are the options you have in MD-04. This MD-06 is collect to access and all, you can use the transaction code. MRB controller. So it will display all the materials. So mostly MD-01, 02, 03, 04, 05. So these are mostly we'll use it. Okay. Any doubts you can ask me, guys?
No, we use all of that in our day-to-day job, so that's quite clear.
And I will show one process. Now, normally, PP integration with QM, quality management. In the production order, now for example, I will go to some existing production order, CO03, enter. If you click on assignment tab, are you able to see here inspection lot is there?
Okay.
You're not getting right. Inspection. Why? Because this material is not subjected for quality. Suppose okay. If it is subjected for quality, it will generate the inspection lot. I will show one cycle now. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So this PP integration with QM takes place at the time of production order release, next at the time of production at the time of GR with reference to production order. Okay.
Yeah.
Now I will use the same material, guys. What is our material? Now let us say finished material, plant and show location, execute. Now you have a stock of 3000, right? Keep this thing as it is. We'll use the same material. I'll go to MM01. Finished material. In the select views, I'll select quality management.
Okay.
So at what stages this material should go for quality, we'll maintain it. So in the quality management view, click on inspection setup.
Alright.
Click on inspection types. Now here I'll select the inspection type, that is 03, in process inspection for production order. Next 04, final inspection at GR for production.
Okay.
At this stages, this material should go for quality. So I click these indicators, press enter. Save. Then I will maintain the quality inspection plan QP01. Material plan key date. Enter. Usage 5. Goods receipt 4. From lots is 1. Click on operations. Control key I will maintain. QM01. Inspection at the time of GR. Give some text message. Enter. Go back. Select this line item and click on quality inspection characteristics. And these are not normally done with the quality management guys. The PP consultant will nowhere involved here. I will enter master inspection characteristics, which is already there in the system, 8-103. And I'll maintain some sampling procedure. Percentage 10 minus percentage. Enter. Then you save the. Okay, inspection plan is created. Now I will run the cycle. Now see here. Create a production order. See the difference now. Enter the quantity. Accept. Check the material availability. Error. See here. During availability check for order. It means stock is not there for subcomponents of 1000. So we'll go and check the stocks for subcomponents. Oh, we have the stock, right? Okay. Now, save. Now release the production order. Now we have maintained two inspection types. At the time of order release, at the time of GR with reference production order. Now you enter the production order, press enter. Now all of you see guys in assignment tab, what happens? The moment you release the production order, inspection lot will be created here. Are you able to see guys here?
Yes.
Yeah.
Quality inspection lot has been created. Previously it is not displayed, but now it is displaying because this material is subjected for quality inspection. Apart from that, in the goods receipt tab, where the stock is under quality inspection.
Right.
Okay. Save. So this is the first stage. Material inspection is done during release. Now confirm. Final confirmation. Clear reservation. Save. So confirmation save. Now, 1 second. Now you go to GR creation, MIGO. Item, okay. So stock type is under quality inspection. Now you save it. See the difference. So far we have created so many GRs for production orders, right? Now this time see the difference. So yeah. GR is created. Now I'll keep this screen as it is. If you go to stock overview, check whether the stock will display under 3000, under unrestricted or quality inspection. Refresh.
Okay.
where the stock is displayed, guys?
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
It is under quality inspection. Because, yeah, again, the material is inspected after the creation of GR for the production order. It means for this 1,000 tons, inspection lot is created after GR. Now I'll show it. In the GR screen itself, instead of GR, you select the option display. Display is done, again as a material document, execute. Now in the item details, under quantity tab, are you able to see, guys?
Yeah,
inspection,
yeah,
lot is created.
Okay.
If you click on this inspection lot, system will take to the transaction code QA03. Okay. QA03 is to display inspection lot. Okay. Now see, we are in display inspection lot. Here it displays a plan, inspection lot number, your finished material. What is the inspection type? 04. You can see your GR document, your production order. Then click on inspection lot quantities. For how much quantity you have done the production order? For 1,000 tons. Out of 1,000 tons, they took the sample of 100 tons of the material and they have checked it. Inspection specifications, inspection plan. And if you click on use suggestion, see here. The inspection is not validated. Still it is under accepted or rejected. We don't know. Still it is not validated. It means this inspection lot may be accepted or may be rejected. So the other reason validation code is displaying as not validated. And user decision is not had been made. Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Now the quality people will result the recording. QE01, record the results. So QE01 is a QM transaction code. Record the results for the inspection lot. Enter the inspection lot number. Just you press enter and save. The results are saved. And finally, we need to take the decision. QE11, record usage decision. See, guys, if you want to display one particular inspection lot, QA03. If you want to see list of inspection lots for a particular material, QA32. It's a very important transaction code in QM model. List of inspection lots for a material. It may be any material. Now before decision taken, I'm showing you in QA32. So that it will be understand for you. R-TM005. Now here I'll select all inspection lots.
Okay.
Execute. Now see here.
Yeah.
It is displaying two inspection lots. One which you have done at the time of order release, and the second one is still it is under process, so the other is displaying green color. Okay, now
yeah,
we'll take record usage decision. Go to the transaction code QE11, enter the inspection lot number, press enter. Under the characteristics tab, you have UD code. UD code means usage decision code. Drop down. Yes. Accept. Then click on inspection lot stock. Now the stock is going to move from quality to unrestricted. If okay, you want to accept. Suppose after checking the quality, if it is under bad condition, move to scrap, or move to block, or return delivery to vendor, as you wish.
I want to move to scrap 300.
Yes, you can move. Okay. Where?
Yeah, yeah.
Come again. Yeah, you are saying?
I'm saying I wish to move 300 to the scrap, if you can't do that way.
Yes, 700 here, 300 here.
Okay.
Like that. So, unrestricted will text for only 700, not for 300. Got it? Or else, I'll keep 100 here, okay?
Okay.
The remaining 100 block stock.
Okay.
Okay. And remaining for sample usage. That is it.
That's fine.
Now you save it. Usage decision has been saved. Now, right. If you go to stock overview, see here. How much stock will be in the quality or how much stock will be unrestricted. And in blocked stock also, you can see the stock. How much okay. It is there.
Yeah, just refresh.
If you refresh, that's it. See? 3,000 has become 3,700.
Yes.
And see the block stock? 100.
Right. 100 was rejected, yeah? Is anywhere show that?
Yes. Scrap, you cannot see. It's declared as a scrap. Okay. Now, if you refresh QA32 transaction code, that's it, which changes to green color.
All right.
And if you want to see the total QEL03 usage decision, you can see it displays validation code as accepted. It means we have accepted that. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you click on inspection lot quantities, click on metal document. See here, how many metal documents have been created? 1, 2, 3, 4. If you click on this metal document, see here, quantity, where? It is under 350. What is the movement of 350? Block to quality inspection. So like this, the integration of PP with QM takes place. Suppose, again, if you go to the metal master, MM02, select use. I don't want to maintain the quality settings, quality management, enter, enter the plan, click on inspection setup, select and delete. Again, select and delete. That's it. Again, there is no inspection of the material. Got the point, guys? Okay.
That's it, done.
Yeah. So, any doubts you can ask me, guys?
No, I think.
Do I have any questions?
Yeah, we'll maybe ask on email if we do. It's been a long day.
Okay, guys. Thanks for your valuable time.
And we're done. No, thank you very much for everything.
Thank you for that. Thank you very much for your help.
Welcome, guys.